More breaking update coming in. A national human rights chairperson, Arun Kumar Mishra, has said that any such comment, which is like the one that has been made by the Congress MLA, are highly condemnable. However, he added that he won't deliberate anything on that specific comment for now.
I am not commenting on the what kind of whether where it has been made, whether it was a privileged place to make such a statement. But these kind of any incident of rape is really very, very shameful incident. Fine, should not happen in a civilized society.
And on this broadcast, in order to discuss this very important issue, I'm joined by Nirmala Samant Prabhavalkar, a former NCW member on this topic. Ma'am, thank you so much for sparing your time on this. But what we can see is, you know, at the end of the day, it all becomes a political haranguing match. That one party will say something about the other, things will go on, people will forget. The very same parties who are now raising, you know, issue and, you know, commenting outside the parliament or in the assembly today, they never said anything yesterday. So that's the problem. The problem is that at the end of the day, none of the political parties actually would wake up unless and until there's some sort of a strong reaction which comes out. Because yesterday we saw, including the speaker and other members on the floor of the house, were laughing on this joke.
Yeah, you're questioning me. Should I answer?
Yes, ma'am.
You are absolutely right that at the end of the day, when it happens, the political party should absolutely come out strong with a strong reaction and must protest. And not only protest will be a very milder thing. There should be some kind of action against people like this. It doesn't matter which political party is there, but if the political party is only correct and take good action against such type of people, then only there will be a good and clean atmosphere in politics. One can imagine the people who get elected by the people. Even there are large number of women voters, and women vote for one of the agenda is to protect and safety and security. And it's the legislative assembly, the lawmaking forum. And when the law is already there, how can one MLA can talk about law breaking and indirectly justifying and glorifying that if you can't tolerate, then you enjoy? What is this? I mean, even a person, non-political also speaking like that also was not tolerable. But more than that, when a person who is so much responsible takes vow on in the name of constitution, and in that constitution, he takes oath that I will abide by the law of the land, can't political parties remember what is the importance of the oath? Taking oath means what? So it is very shocking that whoever, it may be Congress, it may be BJP, it may be whoever, it is not a political party which is important. It is the wrong demeanor, wrong and very horrible expression towards women. How can a person think for women like
right.
this? And some of your students told just now, it's a criminal offense. And yesterday, there were 9 years of post-Nirbhaya case. And
exactly.
With that background, when the parliament has amended the Criminal Amendment Act, these legislators, are they not aware that not to speak like that, it amounts to serious offense also?
That's exactly right, ma'am. We were, in fact, highlighting that point itself, that this is happening on a day on December 16th, which is known by everybody as the day which has seen one of the worst assaults on women, on a woman in the country. And it is on that very day when this kind of an insensitive remark is passed by a Congress, by any lawmaker for that matter, in this case, of course, in Congress MLA. Nirmala Samant Prabhavalkar, thank you so much for joining us in this discussion.